end Teacher Appreciation Week with some of our favorite teachers. So, Andre, you're going to get in here too. But here's mine right now, Mr. Art Cranston. It's actually Kenmore East Senior High School, not Copley High School.
And
so
mine.
I don't know where you came up with that.
But mine is Renee Page, assistant principal at Shaker Heights Middle School.
And mine is Mrs. Joan Jeunnette. She's the physical science teacher at Cornerstone Christian Academy in Willoughby. Very fine lady that I've known for, my goodness, it's been 14, 15, 16 years, maybe longer.
I believe the most important profession out there right now, they're guiding the future.
Sure, especially you look back at like a fourth grade teacher, fifth grade teacher.
Absolutely.
When you're kind of getting your brains formed.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, a great teacher at that age, spectacular.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Spectacular weather forecast, you think?
Yes, and you caught me getting ready for it. I was just kind of shimmying.
It's all right. Mm.
Always busy.
Yeah, absolutely.
Always working.
And trying to shoo all the muckleheads out there. Oh, my word.
Bad.
This is the fourth day in a row. They came on May the 9th. And, of course, you got your introduction to muckleheads,
didn't
you?
This is my first mucklehead year.
Did they freak you out?
A little bit, but a lot of people warned me, so I was kind of
prepared. They don't bite. They're just weird.
Yeah, they're just
very weird.
Yeah.
And they're dead on my desk, too. I find them dead
everywhere. They're all in the newsroom.
Yeah. After 48 hours, they kind of, you know, they're your new compost pile. So, anyway.
Yuck.
Yeah, yuck is right. They stink after a while, too. All right, right now we are close to 70 degrees. We are at 70 at Hopkins Airport. A little bit cooler, not by much, by the lake. Very light lake breeze, but all of the winds today have been very light. This is the wind field as of this afternoon. And you can see the high pressure is right about here because the high pressure has the wind flowing out from it. Of course, in a clockwise direction, and you can follow the center of the high pressure system as we put this into motion. This is a computer model that will push us out 48 hours into the future. As the high moves away, you'll see the wind field increase out of the southwest. Here comes the cold front, though. Look at that, a wind shift on early Sunday morning, and that will be accompanied by perhaps some scattered showers for Mother's Day. Sorry, Mom. But there'll be a few, at least it won't be widespread, nor will it be a deluge. But I think we're going to be getting wet in places. 70 Cleveland, 75 Detroit, pretty close to normal. Normal high 68 degrees. Here's the satellite. This is really the stunning part. In fact, I've confirmed it with the high-resolution visible satellite. There is not a single cloud that we can tell anywhere in Ohio, and that really is amazing. We have to go into Pennsylvania to find those little popcorn cumulus clouds, humble heaps in Latin. We do have that system to the west, and here it is, low pressure in Dallas, and a cold front here will combine, work in our direction. There's the front now, but high pressure tonight, clear skies. We're in pretty good shape. Here comes the front. The front will begin to throw clouds our way tomorrow afternoon, but tomorrow morning we'll have a wonderful start. Late in the day, maybe a few showers in northwest Ohio, and those will tend to curl in Saturday night and on Sunday. But for tonight, clear, another cold night, but not as cold as last night. We did get into the mid-30s in places very early this morning. I think we'll be tweaked up by about 5 degrees compared to that, 40 to 45. Tomorrow, beautiful sunny start. Then increasing clouds in the afternoon, but overall dry. And I'll get that pleasant. Sometimes I type so fast that pleasantly it looks a little funny there. It looks funny because it's not spelled correctly. 73. I'll get that fixed.
It happens.
I'm a mad typist. You should see me in the weather office. People stay away. That's why.
Thanks, Andre.
All right.
Very much. All right. A family vacation doesn't have to cost you a fortune this summer.